Hello everyone, we will know what about the present simple. It's a very interesting lesson. Let's start. We use it to talk about first permanent state or facts like I live in London, general truth, for example, the sun rises from the east. Number three, habit. I play football every Friday. I go to school every day. Number four, future timetable. For example, the train leaves at 9 a.m. Second, what about the form? We will divide the personal pronouns or the subject two parts. I, we, you, they. I put the verb stem or in the infinitive form without anything. But in the singular form, or he, she, it, I put the verb in the end of the verb, S-E-S-I-E-S. For example, I read a story. She reads a story. We go home. He goes home. Verb ending in S-O-X-C-H-S-H, I put in the end of the verb, E-S, with he, she, it, or the singular noun. For example, they study English. She studies English. When the verb ends with Y and preceded with a consonant letter, I omit Y and put I-E-S. Like study, it becomes studies. You play tennis. He plays tennis. Play end with Y, but preceded with a vowel letter. I put Y and put in the end of the verb S. Let's start rules for the third person singular with he, she, it. In general, I put S in the end of the verb. For example, work, works, eat, eats, play, plays, swim, swims, write, writes. But verbs ending in consonant plus Y, it's become I-E-S. Like study, I omit Y and put I-E-S. Cry, cries, try, tries, spy, spies, fly, flies. Okay. Verbs ending in O, S, H, C, H, X, S, S, I put in the end of the verb E, S. Like go, goes, wash, washes, watch, watches, mix, mixes, kiss, kisses. Okay. Don't forget. Vowel plus Y, it's become Y-S.